I can't bring in the dog.
The Alcohol Beverage Board meeting of Thursday, February 11th, 2016 is hereby called to order. Real quick, introductions here. I'm Moses Haldane, the chair. Our vice chair, Ms. Linda Palczynski, is absent today. To my left is Ms. Betty Curry, is a member. Mr. Aaron Mathis, a member. And to my extreme left is Mr. Gordon Thompson, our board inspector. To my right is Mr. Kevin Hall, a member. Our board administrator, Tammy Hildebrand. Our board attorney, Mr. James Tanavich. And our alcohol enforcement coordinator, Corporal James Stone. And then, did you want to introduce?
I figure I'll do that when it comes to the.
His time.
His time.
Okay, all right. And
don't forget Susie.
All right, and Susie Wilden, our office assistant, senior office assistant. So first order of business here on the agenda is the approval of minutes for January 14th, 2016, the meeting we held on that day. I'd like to entertain a motion from the board for action on those minutes.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes for the Alcohol Beverage Board meeting Thursday, January 14th, 2016.
I have a motion. I have a second.
Second.
Second from Member Curry. Okay. Discussion? No. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. The minutes are approved. And thank you, Susie, for doing these.
Now, just
moving right along to new business, just administrative things here. Have officer member trade name changes. First up, there is a Heavy Hitters Bar and Grill removing Glenn E. Buckler Sr. And no one else is coming on.
No one else is coming on.
Okay, so we're still covered.
Tammy Buckler is the will be the sole licensee now.
Okay. All right. So what I need then is a motion from the board for that removing Glenn E. Buckler Sr.
I make a motion that we remove Glenn Buckler from Heavy Hitters Bar and Grill. Glenn E. Buckler Sr.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Member Mathis. Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. Change is approved. Next, I have 2000 Liquors removing Bob Duhal.
Bagabai.
Bagabai.
Mm-hmm.
P. Patel. Did I get a motion from the board on that?
So moved.
Can't pronounce it, so.
Right. And do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Member Hall. Okay, so this one, again, just.
Everything's fine. We still have a resident. The remaining members, officers, will be staying on.
Okay. All right. Anything else? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That change has been approved as well.
I'm not seeing anybody from tourism.
Other business. I have on the agenda St. Mary's County Division of Tourism, Carolyn Ray, but I don't see her.
Yeah, they asked for the audience. They guess something else came up.
Yep. Okay. We'll go through the rest of the agenda, and if they come in before the meeting ends, we'll entertain their pitch there. Okay. Next up, then, I would have the board administrator.
We lost. There will be, we have grant funding currently for the RAS Tipsy Taxi program. That grant funding expires September 30th. Application for the following year is usually this month. However, I have been informed that MHSO will not be funding any more grant money towards our program, and it's nothing against RAS or Tipsy Taxi. It's just that they're closing off all the smaller grants. They're looking sometime in the future that maybe they can find a state source to put all these types of alcohol education from the various boards in the state together, and they'll all dip into one fund. I don't know. Sometimes those one funds don't really work well for little counties. Mm. So you guys had already discussed with legislation putting in that proposal to make RAST mandatory, that, you know, in case the grant did dry up, there would be funding for it. So we have one quarter of next year's budget covered by the grant and the remaining three quarters not covered, which I've added into the budget, and that would be the change.
Okay. Basically, just regards to the budget, it's just an amendment, and just to add that it's one of the things that I kind of expected,
right,
in a way. At some point, I didn't expect it this soon.
Right. So, no, neither do I.
Right. So.
And honestly, MHSO did send me the grant paperwork for the following year, and I kept calling them because I needed to know how much money I was getting total before what funds, and then they kept stalling in the last, oh yeah, by the way, never mind. So I did not know if you needed to withdraw what you had approved last month for our budget and then approve the new draft, because this draft has not been presented. The draft that you approved the budget you approved last month was not presented to the county commissioners as of yet. They are holding us, I'm going to run it up tonight, right after the meeting, okay? It was due yesterday, so they haven't even gotten it on their agenda yet. So we're just going to put in, so I don't know if the board wanted to withdraw their previous approval and approve the new one, or how you wanted to do this. But
yeah, well, I think what I'll do is, I could do it myself, but I'll just ask for the motion from members that we withdraw the previous budget approval on the 14th of January of this year to be replaced by this amended budget effective today. Okay. Someone can do that for me. I'd appreciate it. We had the read-ahead look at this, and it looked fine to me.
It was just minor, just had to add it in. And just like I said, if they approve it, just realize I only put it in for the three quarters prorated of what the grant was. The grant was $7,500. So 75% of that.
And that's, that budget is based on past?
Past grant funding.
Right.
Which realize I couldn't utilize because of the Made in USA regulation, which now I can and will. So, this year, when we get our final numbers at next year's budget, you're going to see that the grant was exhausted, probably, or close to it, versus where I was only using like 10% of the money.
Okay. All right. But there, you don't expect any escalation?
No.
Okay. All right. So, again, I'd regards to the budget amendment, I'd like to entertain a motion from the board for action on approval of this amendment.
I'll make a motion that we withdraw the previous budget amendment that was approved on January 14th meeting of the Alcohol Beverage Board, and we approve the current iteration of the budget amendment to cover funding for RAS Tipsy Taxi programs included.
Okay. Have a motion, do I have a second?
I'll second it.
Second from Member Curry. I think we've talked about this one enough. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Motion has been approved, and so we will submit this amended budget.
Thank you.
Do you have anything else, Ted?
That's it. I am waiting for news on the yearly state meeting. Should be coming down the pipe soon. I'll let you guys know as soon as I get any registration or information on what topics are going to be talked about. Okay. And it's renewal time. We're doing pretty good. People are coming in pretty steadily, which is good. So, and trying to get there any changes done before the renewal. So, working out good.
Again, a very busy time in the office for you and Susie. Mm-hmm. Renewal time.
It's busy.
We're at it.
Okay.
We're on it.
All right, great. And thanks for the good work again on the budget. Appreciate that.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Okay, alcohol enforcement coordinator.
In the month of January, there was three open containers on Great Mills Road where people were arrested for open containers. There's 25 DUIs through the month of January. 24 were people above 21 years of age. One person was arrested under 21, who was 18, for DUI. Conducted 31 total checks of various bars, retail establishments, and parks. Tammy, myself, and Garland did a responsible alcohol service training on January 26th at the governmental center, where we had a full house of people attending the training class, and we taught them all the local rules and regulations and responsible ID training, and that was pretty successful. And posted the violation on the door of the brass rail after the alcohol board hearing last month, and their suspension is due to be up this weekend on Saturday. So I had to pick up the alcohol license from Tammy to return it back to the business, and they're paid up, they're fine, so they're good to go. So they start operating their thing. I've talked to a few board members that I've seen in public every now and then. Recently, I'm going to be leaving the alcohol enforcement coordinator position and going to the schools. Greg is here. He's going to be taking over my position, Greg Rorsick. He's a retired Maryland State Police officer. After retiring from Maryland State Police, he came over to work for St. Mary's County Sheriff's Office in the Criminal Investigations Division, where he's investigated child abuse cases over the past 7 years. And he's going to be filling my position and taking my spot. I'm going to be training him the next couple weeks on the things that I do. Already introduced him to Tammy. He's met Susie before. He's met Betty at the courthouse one day. And so I think he's going to do a really great job. Even before me and him got together and started talking about the position, he already started researching things from the alcohol board, had things printed up, had the rules and regulation book in hand, and was talking to me about the rules and regs. So he's gonna really fit in well with the alcohol board. And it's been pretty good. You guys mean a lot to me, and I'm gonna miss Tammy. She's
let the book show that you will be missed terribly.
Yes, very.
So, It's a bit of family. All you guys do so much for the community that people don't realize how much you guys do. There's been board members that have come and gone that, you know, I'm glad to know. And I'm going to miss you guys. So.
Miss too, very much. Yeah,
we'll see you on the road, we hope.
You're a good man.
We know where you'll live.
Yeah. I promised myself I wasn't going to cry.
You're not by yourself, though.
You know, everything that the board's done for the community, before I took over alcohol enforcement, I really had no clue what the alcohol board had entail. I knew that I did my job as a police officer on patrol, and I handled cases in numerous places. And there's lots of things that may have, should have come before the board before I became alcohol enforcement coordinator. But then realizing all the rules and regulations and all the things that are the businesses are responsible for, made me realize how important the alcohol board is. And there's many businesses that are, you know, do exactly what they're supposed to do for the community, provide a social, fun social location for people to consume responsibly. And the places that did have issues that didn't follow rules and regulations have suffered fines or suspensions or even revocations of their licenses. And, you know, to protect the community in that aspect and work with the business owners has been really, really amazing experience. And it has also changed my perception on police work. The way I talk to people, the way I deal with people day to day, the way I communicate, using discretion, you know, not having to violate everybody, is always working with the businesses, educating them, and giving them the opportunity to correct their actions before it does become a violation. And truly, it's been an experience, and I'm hoping that maybe I get to come back during the summer times when school's out, if my supervisor allows me to work with Greg during the summertime. I'm hoping they might allow me to do it, so it might not be the last time you see me. And I can definitely assure you it won't be the last time you see me, because if I'm out there working and come across violations, I will submit them to the board so I can come testify before you guys again. And also visit you guys too. So I really appreciate everything you guys done for me, and I don't want to ramble on, but the board does mean a lot, and it means a lot to the community, and I hope everybody appreciates them.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Nice to meet you all, and I'm going to do my best to follow Jimmy's footsteps.
We'll help you when we can. Yeah.
Again, just for Corporal Stone, I mean, I've had the pleasure of having him as our alcohol enforcement coordinator for the majority of my time on the board. I mean, just not singing my swan song here at all, but it's been like 9 years. But I mean, Jimmy has been, you know, a definite, you know, asset to this board as a body. And I just think of the things that have been initiated again with
accomplished.
You know, Tammy's help in guiding those things, like the RAST, you know, establishing the RAST, and that became, you know, a very effective method of preventing, you know, violations. And that's what's all about. And I think that kind of leads, you know, lends itself to what Jimmy mentioned about, you know, a different way of looking at things. You know, it's, we don't want the violations. We really don't. I mean, but it's, you know, so again, it's just the RAST is, I think it really did what it was designed to do. And, you know, for, you know, Jimmy Stone, he was a big part of that as well. As, you know, Garland and the regular, you know, everyday members of that are there in the office. You know, we at times kind of get the benefit of that, you know, but again, those are the worker bees and the ones that do those, that good work. So again, I appreciate it. Unfortunately for you, you have a very big shoes to fill. I mean, in at least from my perspective, but I welcome you. You know, again, you'll get the support from the board, because again, it's just one of the things that it's an important piece of what we do. Okay. But again, welcome aboard. And Jimmy, we'll definitely have worked something out. You're not going to go away with it empty-handed. So,
that's good.
Again, thanks for your work.
Thank you, guys. Really appreciate it.
Okay. All righty. Board Inspector.
Yes, sir. For the month of January, beside the calls to noncompliances and reports and everything, I inspected 13 establishments for the month and also did 5 follow-ups for the month. Also taught my portion of the RAS class for Jim and Tammy. And during the month, I also got our alcohol board vehicle inspected and serviced during that time.
He's got the best running post-police work vehicle in the county, I'm telling you.
With shiny tires, too.
Probably.
Very good. Again, appreciate all the work, Garland. I'm surprised we don't have somebody in here requesting something.
Maybe they won't bring them up.
It's that 10-day, you know, you can correct it.
Uh-huh.
Okay, great. But appreciate your work as well.
Praise God. Glad to be here.
But again, just for your information, you should know this, that you'll definitely be working closely with Garland as well. So. All right. License Beverage Association.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon, Mr. Dent.
David Dent on behalf of the San Marcos County Licensed Beverage Association. I just have a couple things to talk about today. Legislation, of course, going on in Annapolis. I did contact Delegate O'Donnell this past week to see what was going on with the legislation that we had asked for the alcohol board, the new legislation for this year. And the reply from his office was because of the number of bills that were being produced this year, that the office that produces the bills were just a little bit behind, but they were still in process. So I don't have any news to report on the county bills that we had asked for this year yet. I do want to talk about a couple of other bills. House Bill 345 is a dram shop bill that's been introduced. So we're monitoring that. I think everybody, you know, I've talked about that before, so I think everybody understands what that is. Also back this year is a bottle deposit bill. It's House Bill 862, and I believe it's cross-filed as Senate Bill 367. And again, that would require bottle deposits. We're trying to make sure that the legislature understands that we're trying to take care of not having to start a new program, a bottle deposit program in Maryland, by using all businesses. We encourage to use single stream recycling to try to alleviate the problem of what to do with excess bottles and things and such. So that's the perspective we've had in prior years. And again, you know, that's the perspective that we'll have this year, that it's more efficient to use the current system that's in place now rather than trying to create redemption centers and, you know, it'd be charging consumers more because they'd be paying their deposit. And then, you know, to get their deposit back, they'd have to bring it back to a redemption center. It's just a pretty complicated system for something that we think that it's already being handled with single stream recycling.
But Dave, before you leave that one, but this bottle deposit,
yes, sir,
is not only alcoholic beverages. This
it's
is
any, all, but all any, correct. Yes, sir.
In a glass.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, this isn't just alcoholic beverages. It's containers.
Right. Any
container.
Any beverage container or anything.
Right.
This is statewide as opposed.
Statewide bill. Yes, ma'am. Another interesting bill that I don't know too much about that just was submitted, I think it was Tuesday evening. It's House Bill 931. It's an alcoholic beverage license for warehouse shopping clubs, a beer or wine license. And it's pretty specific. Like I say, I don't know too much of the details or why it was exactly introduced, but it would allow for a Class A license for a warehouse club for off-sale beer and wine being sold by the case, I believe. And then it's pretty specific. It has, you know, a minimum of 120,000 square feet of retail and storage area. It's in an enterprise zone that's defined. It's within 10 miles of the state border, and it may not operate a gasoline service station. So it's a pretty specific bill, so I'm not too I don't really understand it unless it's just a start towards allowing warehouse clubs or chains to.
This isn't like a Costco type when you say warehouse, but it's just another.
Like a BJ's or Costco's or a warehouse club.
Club. Okay.
Like I say, I don't know any specifics on it because it just was introduced literally 2 days ago. So I guess we'll find out more about it as we go along. And other than that, I believe that's all I have for you today, unless anybody has any questions. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you,
Dave.
Thanks, sir. Community Alcohol Coalition.
So this January and February are kind of slow months, you know, after the holidays, so we haven't had too much going on. But I'm working with Officer Stone if he still wants to do it, the fraudulent ID training in March. So in March, we plan on trying to do those around the spring break time, maybe before spring break gets out. In March, also, there's a parent and youth drug summit that the schools are putting on that the CAC will also be attending in March to get the word out. And then we're just looking forward in the year, and, you know, April is Alcohol Awareness Month. So I'm sure we'll be trying to do a lot of planning in that month for CAC activities. And then then Tammy, you know, at the LBA meeting, we discussed, you know, the RAS grants going out. So I don't know how much that grant is, but maybe CAC, I can look into the MSPF funding and maybe we can help out somehow. Because, you know, RAS is like such a big thing. So I don't know if you want to get together and maybe we can discuss.
I believe even if that increase in the budget is approved, I would still be looking for partnership with to help keep costs budget-wise down.
Yes, I don't know if it's more of just like materials you need.
Whatever, you know, you guys do a lot of PR work for us, you know, putting out ads and sending out flyers and whatnot, and that's been a lot of help.
Yeah.
Getting the word out.
So we want to maintain that partnership, so we would, you know, love to help, and then we can look at the budget because, you know, we have 5 years worth of funding. So we can always maybe add that into our budget for RAS training within the next year. So I guess we can just keep an eye on that and look into doing. I can always look, and we can discuss at the CAC meeting too. I'm sure that wouldn't be a problem with us offering our assistance. Too much. Our next CAC meeting is February 23rd at 6 o'clock at MedStar St. Mary's Hospital and Health Connections. Okay. And then, Jimmy, I don't know if are you going to be able to attend?
Doing the town hall meeting for the smoking town hall meeting at Lexington Park Library. That's at, I think it's 5:30 it starts at. So if I get out of there and get a chance to drive down, Greg might be able to attend.
Okay.
Just in case, but he might be at the meeting with me too, so he's aware of all this stuff. But I'll try to make it over there.
Okay, because I know the CAC's going to be upset when I tell him that you'll be leaving. But we want to thank you for all your help and assistance throughout the year. Glad to see you leave. But I mean, that's all we really have going on. And if you guys have any questions.
Again, appreciate your comment about, you know, Jimmy as well. That, you know, I know that he has, been a big key player in that establishing that partnership with the with CAC and Like I said, it's...
Yep, it's then.
I knew this day was going to come one day.
I think you jinxed me last meeting when you're like, so you're going to be sitting around for a while. But yeah,
he told me with Greg in front of him when he came to my office. He brought Greg with him.
Yeah, he did that to me too.
Don't forget us when you get to the top.
Yeah. Right. I definitely won't forget anybody.
But thank you guys.
All right,
thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to say to all the gentlemen, don't forget that this weekend is Valentine's
Day.
I reminded Jimmy, and he had to write it down, so. He had to. I thought maybe somebody else might.
I'll have to write it down again.
Okay. Okay. Well, I'll see. Kevin's right.
Darn.
I'm working on it.
But just don't want anybody to forget, because it's very important.
Okay. But again, just it's an equal opportunity kind of place.
That's true. That's
kind of
true.
Way.
Yes, very true.
Oh, is that right?
Can't tell from the commercials.
I did buy my card.
No.
I bought my card.
What do you guys want for Valentine's Day? I know the traditional, what you get the woman, but, you know.
You don't have to go to Jared's or whatever that.
I was going to say.
Let me watch my sports.
There you go. Steak dinner.
There you go.
Put that in your merch, John.
Well, for Aaron, it's, you know, steak and cheese. Yeah. That's easy.
Record how long it took.
So, but appreciate
it. I got fried oysters for dinner last night, so that was my
very good
Valentine's dinner.
Alrighty. See, I still don't see a St. Mary's County.
Will they reschedule or
tourism?
They scheduled it with us and went back and forth. So.
And we can.
I'll give them a call when I get back to the
office.
We'll
see if maybe to defer that and postpone it until next meeting if they're going to be available. It was just something that an opportunity for them to speak on
glad
plans.
Glad interested in here with that.
Okay, that clears our agenda for today's meeting. So I'd like to entertain a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
And a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
I want to stay longer.
It's adjourned.